I'm gonna tell you more about this once we have done the unboxing, but yeah, I'm so excited. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today I have another unboxing video for you. And yes, I know that I've only recently purchased my Bulgari Serpenti Forever and the beautiful like green Karung skin from Vestiaire Collective, but I found another beauty on Vestiaire and I absolutely love this one so, so much. I mean, let's see what I think about it when I see it in real life. But from the pictures that I've seen, and I asked the seller to actually send me many, many more pictures than she actually uploaded, and she did it within like a day. And I would always advise to do that if you're interested in a bag at Vestiaire on Vestiaire Collective. Then always ask the seller to, you know, show you more pictures. First of all, you know if the seller is active, you know, if they're actually still selling the item. If an item is online for a longer time, you never really know, right? If the seller is still intending to sell it. And secondly, of course, you get more images and you know what you get yourself into. So yeah, what can I say? We have another unboxing today and I'm really excited for this one. I'm gonna tell you more about this once we have done the unboxing, but yeah, I'm so excited. Okay, so let's do this. This is a bigger box than last time. And by the way, I've already taken out my Bulgari Serpenti in the Emerald Green Karung skin. If you haven't seen my London luxury shopping vlogs yet, please go and check them out. I was so happy that I could finally be like outside again and see the outside world again and just like go shopping. I missed Harrods quite a lot, let's say. But yeah, so that was an amazing day. It was like Monday, the 15th of June, and it was the first day that the shops basically were reopening. And I just made the decision that I had to go that first day to get my luxury fix. But yeah, so let's do this. This is the box, and it's so much bigger than the other box that I got. And the bag should not be that much bigger, actually. So, I really like that they stuff it so nicely. I can always just like use the paper to probably stuff the bag again immediately, which is quite nice. Okay, let's see. I don't know if it comes with the original dust bag or anything again. Oh, it looks like it does. Okay, are you ready? You can already see something. Oh, yeah, 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 wait. Let me hide this. Ooh. Okay, guys. Yes. Can you see this? Oh. Yes, I did get another Bulgari bag. Some of you might already know what this is because I've mentioned it in the comment section quite a lot of times. And in one of my other videos, I'm pretty sure I mentioned that I feel like I've recently been bitten by the Bulgari bug. So, you know, I mean, I don't know, I've always loved Bulgari bugs. I've always loved the Serpenti Forever line. And I do now have four Bulgari Serpenti Forever bags in my collection, but yeah, we get into this. So this bag, oh, let's see, I've just seen a little bit, like, ooh, let me get rid of all of this first. Just gonna push this. Okay, so comes with the original dust bag and it smells like perfume, so it's good, it's not a bad smell or anything. Okay, wait, the bag is open. Let me close it. Oh my god, okay. So, to reveal my new to me Bulgari Serpenti Forever in the medium size in the beautiful charcoal diamond gray stingray skin, stingray leather. Oh my god, I just need to look at it for a second. So, of course, it is a pre-loved bag again. And there is definitely some wear and tear on the leather. And I have to look into this. But like with what I did with my other bag recently, if a bag comes with scratches, I'm pretty good in terms of like buffing scratches out. And I just use like a regular leather cleaner and I go over it. And usually it looks a lot better immediately. Okay, so here is the beautiful bag. And like I said, so the top part basically is stingray leather and the bottom part is calfskin leather. And stingray is usually a pretty, pretty expensive exotic leather. Usually they are more expensive than like any kind of like python bags or any kind of snake skin bag. And it's still below lizard, like if we talk about the ranking of exotic leathers, but it's a ridiculously expensive leather. So of course this bag is not entirely made out of stingray. We only have the top flap basically that's made out of stingray. And yeah, but I mean, look how beautiful it shines. Okay, let me give you a close-up shot of the bag. Oh, isn't it absolutely beautiful? So I've never had a gray bag in my handbag collection ever. And I thought maybe it's time to add a nice gray to my handbag collection. And so yeah, we have to look at the wear and tear of the bag. This bag was described as in very good condition. And like I said, it's always kind of like a hit or miss kind of thing with Vestiaire Collective. And I would say the other Bulgari bag that I recently got, if you haven't seen that unboxing, then go and check that one out too. That one was described as in good condition, and I definitely agree, because it had like a scratch, it was worn, but nevertheless I was able to buff it out, I stuffed the bag, it looks like new. With this one, I have to say the stingray is in beautiful, beautiful condition, so there is nothing wrong with it. The calfskin, however, does come with a couple of scratches, and a little bit of like the leather is a little bit wrinkled. Let me see if I can come closer to you. So, okay, let me give you a close-up shot. That is the beautiful snake head closure with the green malachite eyes. Absolutely perfect, no scratches. The stones look absolutely perfect as well. The stingray is beautiful and shiny. Nevertheless, I'm always cleaning my bags, like if I get a pre-loved bag. And this is the back of the bag. Oops. So yeah, you can see like there's a little scratch, but it's all surface scratches, I think. If I clean the bag, I'm pretty sure that those will, you know, disappear again as well, like with my other one. However, I can see here at the front, let me see, can you see this? Wait, where is it? Here. There's like a little scratch that is a little bit deeper, and there are a lot of wrinkles. And I think that's normal if a bag like this gets worn a lot. There are some surface scratches as well, but I'm pretty sure I can get those out. I think the wrinkles, like I said, I think is absolutely normal. This is a very, very smooth calfskin leather. I think you see wear and tear quite easily. Let me see how the corners look like. They look absolutely amazing. So if we focus in on that, it's still in pretty, pretty good condition. These sides usually show wrinkles as well with the Bulgari bag, simply because you squish them and you know, depending on how much stuff you put in your bag. And yeah, okay, let's look inside. Oh, okay, the inside flap surprisingly looks really, really good. There are no scratches, because usually when you go in and out of your bag, your fingernails, right, tend to scratch the bag, but this looks pretty good. And this one comes with a beautiful green interior leather lining, and it's absolutely stunning. So what I can already feel, because I have my beautiful metallic leather Bulgari Serpenty Forever in the medium size, and the rose quartz and pink rose quartz leather. And with that one, it is so stiff because it's still relatively new. I haven't worn it that much, and you know, I think the metallic leathers tend to be stiffer in like naturally. With this leather, I can already feel that it's quite easy to, like, you know, stretch your bag and stretch the pockets. So that means I can probably fit more stuff in here, which is great. So as you can see, it has a zipper compartment here at the back. Then you have a zipper compartment in the middle, which is the divider basically. There it comes with a mirror. I'll show you that in a second. And this should be the raincoat for the bag. And then you have another little slip pocket here, and just a regular compartment at the front. So, okay, what I also always check is like the stitching. The stitching still looks fabulous, there's nothing wrong. So you always have to pay attention when it comes to these bits, like no matter if it's like a Chanel bag, Bulgari bag, kind of like any flap bag, you have to make sure that the stitches are not, like, the stitches haven't popped, basically, because there's of course a lot of pressure every time you open and close the bag up. There's a lot of pressure on these stitches here, basically, but yeah, they are perfectly fine. The other thing I always like to check, especially with exotic skins, is that there's no cracking and I've shown you that on my carrying bag as well. Here, where you open and close the bag, exotic leathers like carrong, python, stingray, they tend to crack. And this one is absolutely fine as well on both sides, so there is no cracking. So I would always advise to check that if you get an exotic bag. And yeah, okay, so oops, let me go back to my normal position. And here we do have the raincoat, so that's pretty cool. The bag still comes with everything. This is the little Bulgari mirror. I feel like this little mirror is always a really, really nice addition when it comes to the Bulgari bags. You just always have a mirror with you. This is pretty cool. Let me check the other pockets. Okay, that's empty. Oh, it even comes with all the paperwork, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, I think that's it. This is my beautiful new bag, baby. Look how beautiful it shimmers. I absolutely love it. So with the old medium, not old, but the medium style Serpentine Forever bags that are a little bit older, those bags have a shorter strap drop than the bags you can buy nowadays. So I think what happened, like in the past, a lot of people have complained that if you actually want to wear the bag double strapped over your shoulder, that it sits pretty, pretty high up. And I've never worn my medium-sized Serpentine Forever bags double strap simply because, yeah, it is too high. And especially, I mean, think about the winter time. If you wear a big coat over your regular clothing, like, there's no chance that this is comfortable. So what I have always done as well is just wear it as a single strap, and then it has, like, the perfect height. I would say it still sits higher than, like, your Chanel Classic flap. It definitely sits higher than a jumbo. But nevertheless, this is a really nice height. And with the new bags, the new medium-sized bags, they have a strap drop that's, I think, let's say 10 centimeters more. So you can actually wear the bag double-strapped or single-strapped. So yeah, let me know what you think about this beauty. I know a lot of you have actually decided that they wanted to add a Serpentine Forever bag to their collection as well. And I can only recommend that. It's, you know, it's artwork bags, if you ask me. And quite a statement piece, right? So yeah, definitely let me know if you guys find any perfect dream Bulgari bags for your collection, and let me know which models you pick and so on and so on. And yeah, I hope that you did enjoy today's video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Join our little handbag obsessed family here, because we all do have the same luxury disease. That's what I always like to say. And yeah, have a wonderful day, and I see you guys soon. Bye.